Okay, guys, my name is James. I am the CEO and founder of Biome Detox Secrets. I have made this awesome Facebook group so that, and my other fellow healthcare professionals can provide you insights, really incredible stuff to get you healthy and, reach your optimal health. So without any further ado, I'd like to introduce our honorable guest speaker today, Feni Rupali. She is a nutritionist and a wellness expert, and she will give incredible lecture about how to get rid of excess estrogen. So if you're ready, holla at her, and then we just open your ears up. So let's get ready. So here's to you, Feni.
Thank you, James, and welcome everyone. And I'm just going to share my screen with you, please.
Okay.
I created a presentation.
There you go.
There we go.
There's a pretty one right there. Okay.
Okay. So in my last video, I spoke about what happens if you have excess estrogen and why it can happen. And if you missed it, you can watch it on YouTube or on my Facebook. And now I would like to share a few tips on how to get rid of that estrogen. First of all, just let's do a little bit of recap. So what are some of the symptoms of excess estrogen in your body? Well, if you ever feel gained abdominal weight, which is very hard to get rid of, and you don't even know why you have it, if you have a painful period, brain fog, headaches, sleep issues, you may have excess estrogen. And now we're going to look at some tips on what you can do about it. And the liver is crucial for eliminating used excess hormones. If your liver is clogged, it affects overall hormone levels in your body. Methylation and sulfation are the two most important pathways for your liver for estrogen metabolism. And you can support these pathways by eating. Oh, I went a bit too far. Sorry. So you can support this pathway by eating cruciferous vegetables, like broccoli, cauliflower, Brussels sprouts, kale, radish, and leafy greens. And I can already hear somebody saying, yuck, but trust me on this, they are very good for you. And then, your digestive system also has a major role in getting rid of excess estrogen. So it is important to have a healthy microbiome and regular bowel movements, because let's say if you are constipated, the estrogen that is waiting to be moved out of your body is just sits there for longer, and it has plenty of time to get reabsorbed in your system, and that's not really ideal. So a healthy microbiome comes handy to prevent this to happen. And as James already filled his water bottle, it's important to drink plenty of water, eat your fruits and vegetables, because you need a good amount of fiber to keep your gut happy. Give it some extra support with pro and prebiotic food, such as onions, garlic, sauerkraut, leek, asparagus. And another tip is to include some ginger, like in a form of tea or in your curries, because ginger helps to move things along easier in your bowel. And another thing to consider is estrogens, aka endocrine disruptors, which can be found in many products used on a daily basis, such as your shampoo, your cosmetic product, your cleaning product. And it is important to read the labels, because they are harmful for you, but also add the load you already have of these estrogens on the top of that. So watch out for the labels, phthalates, parabens, and triclosan in every single product you buy. And also some heavy metals in shampoo too, such as aluminium. Check your deodorant for it, they are notorious for aluminium. And mercury and cadmium. And of course, use a lot for plastic water bottles and food containers. So they contain BPA, bisphenol A, which has a strong estrogenic effect. So you can easily reduce this by buying nice glass or stainless steel products, buy a really nice water bottle and fill it up with filtered water during the day, and give yourself a break and use natural products. And the last thing, don't forget to move and relax. So moderate exercise can have major effects on your hormone. So do what you enjoy, whether it's walking, running, yoga, or just dancing around the house. Doesn't matter, do it. It doesn't have to be every day an hour of strenuous exercise. Just here and there, a little bit of movement when you have 1 minute. That's more than nothing. And relaxation, a good night's sleep are also very important to keep your hormones, body and mind happy and healthy. So meditate, listen to music, take a relaxing bath, read your book. Doesn't matter what works for you. Just give yourself a little bit of me time every evening before you go to bed. And that's just a few nuggets of all the things you can do to help move these estrogens out. But hopefully it was helpful. And thank you very much for watching. And if you think you need help to get on top of your health and would like to work with me, please book a free call and we can discuss how I can help you.